Welcome back for holiday time for holiday brunch in the kitchen this morning. Deborah Weiner.
I'm surprised too. But I was very comfortable because I left the cooking to my mother-in-law, who makes the best potato
latkes.
So
you did nothing.
I moderated. You'll see.
Supervised.
Take a look.
All right, we are here making potato latkes, which is the traditional food for Hanukkah. And I'm here with my mother-in-law, Jeannie Gogol.
Yes, it's nice to be with you.
And I know you've been counting down the days to do this with me because you really love this whole concept of cooking on television.
Absolutely.
No, I chose you. Even though you're reluctant, I chose you because I think, hands down, you have the best latkes in the entire Baltimore region.
Thank you for the compliment.
They're wonderful. You eat them in groups of tens, or I do.
Okay.
They're really, really
not
good.
Not me.
Not you.
I can't afford it.
No, yeah, no. None of us can. But it's really, you've been charming. It's pretty simple. So, tell me the ingredients we have.
We have baking potatoes, mm-hmm. Idaho baking potatoes. We need yellow onions.
Yellow onions, okay.
We need an egg.
One egg.
We need
a little bit of flour.
Well, salt and pepper and a little bit of flour,
okay.
Yes.
And you do salt and pepper to taste. And the key is vegetable oil.
Yes, I use a lot of oil.
I know.
So they really sizzle.
They're
hot.
Really
they
sizzle.
Need to be hot and sizzling.
But oil has a significance to this holiday because, I'm going to reduce the story of Hanukkah down to a few seconds here. The miracle of light and the miracle was the miracle of oil, that a little bit of oil lasted for 8 nights in the temple. And that is the miracle of light and the miracle of this holiday. So we use a lot of oil because it has a real reason.
Significant.
Okay, so you've already prepared this mixture here, which is the onion and the potato that you peeled. I watched.
Thank you.
And that we're going to go ahead, and I'm going to let you do this since you're really the woman here.
Well, this also has been drained.
Drained.
It's important that after we mix the potato and the onion that we drain it to get off some of the excess liquid.
Okay.
So we'll put
some of the starch.
Right.
Okay,
the onion juice also. So potatoes, starch, and the onion juice.
Okay. And we want to point out too, Jean, that you double-thinged this. You double-chopped
it.
Right.
In order to get it to this fine consistency, I used the Cuisinart. I used to grate by hand, and that was a job. But now this is easy. I use this attachment to make it coarse,
mm-hmm.
and then I use this attachment. I put a second attachment in.
To make it kind of mushy.
To make it kind of, fine, really fine, because I like it fine and not coarse.
And not fine.
Exactly.
Okay, and so now we add to this mixture,
we add one egg.
One egg. Okay, go ahead and pour that in.
One egg.
Okay,
right.
And then do your little stirry thing.
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Stir and stir and stir and stir.
One egg, and you add salt and pepper to taste.
Taste.
Okay, so how much?
Well, I'm heavy on the salt.
Why is this thing so hard?
Okay. I'm heavy on the salt. Just put in a couple of scoops of salt.
That salt looks weird.
Okay. And some pepper to taste.
And pepper to taste. I know you love this whole grinding concept.
Yep.
Okay.
And
but I think yours are good
up.
And yours are salty. Okay.
And we add
a little bit of flour.
A little flour to give it more firmness or keep it
not
together.
Okay. We're
great
with
the add a little bit more, right.
So it's about a tablespoon or so.
And you stir it up and stir it up.
All
mix
right.
it up, and it's all ready. That's it.
All ready.
So
now,
it's all ready for the pot.
All ready for the pot.
For
all
the very hot oil.
I know.
The oil needs to be very hot.
You'll go closer to it than I will.
Shall I?
Okay, now this is the scary part, where you put this mixture by spoon into this, it's really, really super, super hot vegetable oil.
Right.
Yikes.
And it sizzles. There it goes.
Awesome. That's an old pot. This pot is from, the old country.
Prehistoric
time. The old country.
But it serves its purpose.
All right, they're gorgeous. So you take them out.
I'm taking them out, letting them drain.
On the paper towel.
We want to get off the excess oil.
So they're nice and low calorie.
And they're crispy.
Yay, they look so good. These are the best potato latkes in the entire world. Is this the suck up of all suck ups?
Enjoy.
All right, and we like to serve them with applesauce and with sour cream, and you can dip a little in each one. What do you like to start with, the applesauce?
I like applesauce.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Smells so good.
Oh.
Happy Hanukkah.
Hag Sameach.
She did a great job.
She's fabulous. If you would like a copy of my mother-in-law Jeannie's potato latke recipe, and it's precise on the website. I know you two think it was imprecise, but we have it all down. It's on the website, WBALTV.com. Click on recipes or send us a self-addressed stamp envelope to Sunday Brunch, WBAL-TV, 3800 Hooper Avenue, Baltimore, 21211.